always a pleasure to drive in this area. It's quite challenging and can be challenging at times. Depends on the other road users as well. Because you go 20 miles an hour, 30 miles an hour, then you go tight road. Then you really need to check the mirrors, because here it's just happening all the time. But if we're going to go slowly, steady, that's the perfect way. Excellent. So I'll be stopping soon, because I think the load is not safe anymore. Just drives me nuts, honestly. And another thing, when they load the vehicle, they put all these long things on a small pallet in the middle. Better put one pallet on one side, one pallet on one side, and the load will be straight. Nice. Should have been good to stop there. All these fucking bumpy roads, mate. Everywhere I'm going, bumpy roads, holes. Tend to stop somewhere. Honestly, I don't really like this situation, but it can happen to anyone. You know? It would have been good here. I should have stopped there. Oh, the load is not safe anymore. I just need to stop somewhere. And I've tied that strap. Very strong, and it's still not good enough. Robert, trying to do everything safe, and actually it's not safe. It just completely drives me nuts. Just find somewhere to stop. Because every time the road is getting bumpy, every time the load is jumping around, jumping. This situation. I think I'll just stop there. It says no stopping, but probably I'll just stop there in the road. What is this place here? Loading bay? I don't know. I think this is loading. Loading bay is the next one. I'll just park here, because it's loading only. So I just managed to go outside. I've done that strap again. Well, the stuff on the top just travel little bit, because it's just wet outside. I've done the strap with the whole string, mate. I've just tied it up and it's just moving somehow, because this is the fucking road. I can't do anything about it. As soon as the stuff is staying there, and then suddenly it's just jumping like that. You know, it's just creating additional movement. Well, I think anyway the metal things, they going like that, so in any case they will go in the headboard if I will have to press a harsh brake or something. So in any case we'll keep staying there. I've tightened up the strap, but it's not staying there. What can I do if the load is like that? It just drives me nuts. Completely drives me nuts, honestly. I want to keep myself alright, to do my job safe, but sometimes it's not only about me. It's about the environment as well. It's about the road as well. The loading as well. Because he put it the mesh first, then there's no other space for anything. If you put them thing first, then you cannot put the mesh, because it will squash everything. So in any case, how you gonna load it up, it's gonna be shit. Because this is you got a very hard product, which is mesh. Then you got an the other product, which is different. If I manage to arrive to the first job, then anything else will be so much easier to do. So now another situation that I need to put the brake, press the brake. Going downhill should be okay, but going uphill is not necessarily alright. And I think I'll have a lot of uphills during this journey, so it will not help me at all. Robert, I wish so much to have a permanent job somewhere, to have my lorry, to have my load, exactly my straps, my load, my lorry, my everything. So I don't need to change jobs all the time, all the time. Go there, different environment. Go there, different environment. Go somewhere else, different. It's like, if you don't believe me, walk a mile in my shoes and you'll understand what I'm saying. I hope that I will find all the time these bumps all over, bumps. Just steady road, nice, without do, you know? Yeah. And I think the back axle is doing like that anyway. Doesn't matter what you're carrying. Look where I'm going. I'm going on the snake pass with this. Carrying a load which I don't think it's 100% safe, into one of the most dangerous areas to drive from entire UK. Oh, what a view. 21 miles, Rob, 21 miles. Come on, Rob, I'm sure you can do it. You know what I mean? Like, all I need is a permanent job with a contract, without worrying about anything, without... Wow, can you see that down there? Fantastic. Without worrying about job security, job safety, without worrying about anything, mate. Just go to work, do my 50 minutes of checks, go to deliver, and that's it. And I think I'm gonna stop here, because it's the only place I can find to stop. Or should I stop? No, should be one on the left side. No, I will find something on the left side, because there I'll just cross these solid lines, and then it's not allowed. I literally can see in the mirrors, fuck all, because it's keep raining all the time. So look where I am. Just done 15 minutes of break, and then I just went outside. I just found a different type of textile material, which I just secured that load a little bit better than it was. So I hope that this thing, it will keep it there somehow. So we're on Snake Pass Road here. It's quite a famous road if you want to take your car, yeah, if you want to visit. Well, it's so nice during summer time. Now it's like windy, cold. Usually people here drive with 50, I'm going with 23 miles an hour, mate. I literally just want to finish with the first job, just to make sure everything is done, and then I'll just carry on how it is, because at the minute just need to focus on drive really slow, keep really steady, without harsh brake, without harsh turn, left, right, you know. It's quite embarrassing. What can I do, man? People will swear at me, or they will do middle fingers and that, but maybe one day they will understand why. I think here is the most beautiful road ever in United Kingdom. It's not necessarily the quality of the road is poor, very poor. It's like that. You know, bumpy road, holes, potholes, narrow, dangerous. But the landscape, everything surrounding this place is just magnificent, mate. Caution. Concealed entrance, slow. Anyway, I'm going slow. And I got a van on the back, which literally it will just go in the back of my vehicle, honestly. It's just, if you want to go faster, overtake, mate. You got all the road, look, nobody's coming. If you want to overtake, overtake. I'm just driving safe. So if you want to drive safe, drive. If you don't want, then you just need to wait, mate. I think the load is not moving like how it was moving earlier. Now it's just steady in position, because I just wrap everything around the pallet and I just use a different method, and I think they don't go anywhere. But as a precaution, as a matter of precaution, I just drive slowly, because that will reduce the risk of losing the load. And it's quite embarrassing as well to lose your load. Ooh, la la la. Man, this is the best place you can find here. And it's another one in Cumbria. Same like this. Amazing. And this place is not far from Manchester, actually. I like to have a boat or something and just go there on the water, try to fish, try to catch some fish. Try to relax in the morning. I don't know if I'm allowed to swim there, but will be nice. That's the most embarrassing situation I have ever been on transporting something, that I stayed with the carrot in the ass and the bunny on the carrot as well, you know. It's just all together like a ladder. Yeah, so the view is an empty pallet on top of it, and then put the strap on top. 1 mile away. I need to wait for the green car. I don't know how this traffic light works, mate. I literally just don't know how. Straight on, you got green, and on the right you got red. So why in the world? Because there's nothing else coming from that way. I'll never understand why. I think this area is very difficult to drive. Ground there, you see. So the job must be here somewhere. I think the hospital is further down. Well, it's a nice place, but as a lorry driver, it shows me I need to go around. I mean, the place is exactly in front. I think the sat nav just sees me there. I think all this place is hospital, actually. Yeah, the Royal Hallamshire Hospital. So I need to find a way to go inside the place. But how to find that way, that's the problem. How to find it, mate? I'll try. Ha! This place is for cars, mate. Again, I get this place is for cars and I need to go with the lorry. Let's see if I can... If I cannot find, I need to turn around again. Come on. There's no way I can go there anyway. It might be here somehow. No, no way. where is the place? Where do I need to go? It just fucking drive me nuts. Where to park? Nowhere to park. Ah. All those deliveries in such places I don't really like. And no, like, I'm not allowed to park here. I'm not allowed to park, it's nowhere to park. I need to check my paperwork. Fucking hell, man. I called the customer and literally he told me a name of the road. I'm trying to put that, but it seems like every road that I'm going, it's one-way system. There is some guys doing some deliveries. It's like, don't care at all. Where to go? It's nowhere else, mate. I just need to do my job somehow. How to do my job, how to find the place. When you got tight places like this, honestly, it just make my life so hard, you know? So harder, so hard, whatever, you understand what I mean. Can't find, man, can't find. One-way system. One-way system, tight roads, you want lorry to deliver. It's one of them things. Now put me there. It's a stupid. I'm not allowed to go there anyway. It might be here inside somehow, but I can't go, man. I can't go. I can see some builders, but I think they work for different site anyway. There's the car park, there's the building, maybe is that the whole hospital? Royal Hallamshire Hospital? Find a place. Excellent parking, mate, excellent. Better than this, I don't think you can find anywhere. I think it's here. That's why I cannot find.
Lengths of 6 meters straw.
I've got 10-1, but I'm not sure.
What have you got? Straw.
You see on the other side is the metal bars. See? So literally this is where I have to deliver. Look how tight is there, look how tight is here. And at the end I need to turn right to go under this, which is 11.6, and my lorry, it says it's 10.1. This is what it says. But I'm not sure. It might be bigger than that. I really need to be careful here, mate. So guess what? I just managed to go under the bridge. Look how tight is, mate. You think class 2 jobs are easy, eh? You think there are taking the piss or things like that, yeah? Look, another proof that the job is not easy as you think, because you have to deliver in such places. Mate, I think that guy takes the piss with me. He told me drive on the end of the road and then turn right. Where the fuck to turn right, man? Do you take the piss? I just was there earlier. Where to turn right? You just have to... It's turning right on the other one. I could have taken that from the first time, man. This is taking the piss with me, honestly. Ha! He told me pass this and then turn right. I just was there on that. All right, guys, I've just done the delivery. Honestly, didn't have enough battery to record here. So what can I say is delivery has been done correctly. Now I'm just trying to get out of this place. We'll see if I will be able to get out somehow, because I will try to go a little bit on the pavement. Hopefully this pedestrian will understand, because when I have bends like this, so much difficult. So I had to go around here to come back again on this road. I could have gone from the first time if I knew. So actually the sat nav put it me exactly where I should be, you know, like I was really impressed. So here, just trying to get out here first, then to find the place where I can stop. Yeah. I don't know if there's any camera or anything, I just need somewhere to stop too. Yeah. Road ahead closed, diversion. Finally I went out of that place, because it's just when I got deliveries in city centers and that, sometimes it just drives me nuts, because either I haven't been there yet, either I don't know where to go. It's been so nice, because those guys, they've been so helpful. I just talked on the phone with one of them and fucking stupid, now you put the indicator, you should have put another one. No indicator, man. I just want to get off this place, man. So I went all the way around and then all the way around and then again right turn. Like I literally went under that small bridge passage, what it was, just inches away. Like actually the lorry is 10.1, so I guess was not a lie in that anyway. I touched with the antenna, just here. I could have find this radio one a lot better. And as soon as I turned there, when where the guys told me, it was like left turn and then right turn again, and then all these bollards all over the places. So it's literally so hard if you have to go to that hospital to deliver something. And you'll not be with 18 tonner. If you're with 26 tonner there, you can't take the turn. It's impossible. I barely took it with 18 ton from 4 or 5 maneuvers, which barely goes like that, inches away. Otherwise, and well, I'm a driver that actually goes all the time in narrow places. But if you find someone that doesn't have such situations, or they're just beginners, just on the first day on the class 2, they will just find this situation a lot more complicated than I found it earlier. So another tips that I can give you, sometimes you got lay by like this, that usually if you put a small car you'll not have space for anything else. But to go out you use that door and you need to make mess like this, or you go on the road and you die. And in order to keep everything safe, you plug the mirror in. But if you want to go out, you plug the mirror out, see if anyone will let me out. Because everyone is rushing. So I've done a half an hour break. Now I got 45 minutes all done, completed. Yeah. So we're on our way to the next job, to the second one, which is 34 miles away, somewhere around 55 minutes. Now we're turning to M62. Excellent driver. think it's around here.
Huh?
All deliveries rear of the building. I can see, but the sign is really, really dirty. Can't see properly. Ah, so SIG is here. Why this SIG couldn't deliver to this place? He didn't send me here from Manchester. I don't understand, man. SIG says it's there. They called up to the delivery here. Okay, what do I have to do now? No one's answering. I just give them a call now to see what they say. I'll just stay here 5 minutes, see if someone's come, and then if no one's here. Yeah. Have you been in the front? Try in the front, maybe someone's there. Yeah, cheers, no problem. Now I just have to go with the lorry inside. I don't know exactly where I have to go. Just probably have to wait around here somewhere. Doesn't say delivery is anything. Yeah, there. Okay. I'll just reverse there.
What is it?
Just bars. Metal bars.
Alright, yeah. So
yeah, reverse. Yeah, 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 no problem. Cheers, man. We got 30 bars. They are on the left side, actually.
Just pull forward and out.
Yeah, yeah, no problem. I can't. My jacket is stuck, man. Pain in the ass, fucking can't go out. Come on, fucking jacket. I got stuck inside. My jacket was broken, the door, fucking hell.
Gary, you only screw up. Mom, you only screw up that door.
Yeah. Yeah, I've had a few more earlier, but
both fine or
yeah, both. So should be 30 altogether. I just been to your colleagues in Sheffield earlier.
All right.
Yeah. In that hospital, I forgot the name.
Nightingale.
Hallamshire or something like that. Hallamshire, yeah. Hospital.
Could ring a bell. Though.
Yeah. Wait. Let's see. I waited all day to drop this off, honestly. Just literally, they're going anywhere. Even if you put the strap so tight, just.
They put that on with the straps?
Yeah.
Alright, because that doesn't look, I'll lift it, but it doesn't look very set. It looks all the weights at the
center. Yeah.
See what I mean?
I'll try to move as much as I can.
Well,
Oy. You can try if you want.
It doesn't look fucking balanced.
It's not.
At all, that is not balanced at all. When I pick it up, it's just going to drop.
Yeah. Well, somehow... somehow it's only this and that, but... I don't know.
I can try it, mate, but it's not going to pick up the rope.
Yeah.
These pallets separate, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, I'll do one at a time.
Yeah, mate. Just mind that end, the other end. You see the ball are there. You need to lift a little bit on top. You see the red one?
Can't see it all. That?
Yeah, yeah, well, just, yeah, 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 yeah.
I just want to see how it lifts and then I want to shift it over.
Just keep a hand on it.
That's as far over as I can go.
We'll do it slowly, slowly we'll do it. I know it's not the right thing, but as long as you're happy, I'm happy.
Problem is that I can't go nowhere now.
Well, I can try to roll them forward a little bit.
What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna reverse this, put this here.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't go nowhere because you're truck.
Yeah.
And then we'll get the next one off, you can go on and we can
Yeah, 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 no problem.
So I'm gonna left hand down now.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Staying at that height because I need to clear all this.
Yeah. Teamwork.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm going down now.
Yeah.
Should be alright. It's
alright, yeah. Bend your fingers. All right. Oh, something. This is more balanced than the other one, but still.
This one's even. I like this.
Yeah. Honestly, they didn't know how to load it. They wanted to put this first and then the mesh there, but there's no space for everything. So, if you can count them, should be 30. Should be 30 of them. Okay. Now all I need to do is just to secure the load. Yeah. I cut my nails yesterday, and I think I've done something to my my nail, because the secure is not done yet. Go on, mate. Okay, job done. Everything is safe. This one, everything is safe. Oh yes, Bradford Town Centre, Bradford City Centre. Oh yes, very nice. Very nice, very nice. Turn. Then need to take right turn, and I can take from this lane as well. It's this guy here. Yeehaw, come on. So the job is inside there. I just went there with the lorry. I gave him the paperwork. He told me if I can pack and then reverse it, it might be a lot easier than trying to get in and get stuck in the mud. So at the minute I'm trying to reverse somewhere where I can't see very well. So. Trying to pack this vehicle. Because there is nowhere how to turn it around. So I just need to turn it the other way around and reverse all the way. This is all I need to do. Don't have any idea how to do it, because here is that stilp, bollard, how you call it, post. Yeah, we in Romania say stilp, so that's a stilp. Yeah, okay, maybe I'll try to pack this in here. Put this type of light so they will understand I'm in construction as well. We got Speedy Gonzalez. Got a stilp in the back of the vehicle. I'll manage to do it somehow, don't worry. Rob is here. Rob is having the situation under control. Just to take few more maneuvers, because the street here is just for a skateboard, not for cars, not for lorries. Where are we going now? You want to go somewhere, don't you? Exactly when I need the space, exactly then is someone that needs the same space. That one guy is a lot smarter, because he went on the other side. You understand that I need to back the vehicle. So I don't think I can record anything, because I need to wear my helmet. So I will apologize, guys. Probably this is as much as I can offer you. Just a reverse in a tight situation. Come on. Come on. Let's go and do the unload. That's for you as well. Just fixing screws. Quite heavy. Sorry mate, I forgot the bolts. And the other one as well. still needs a little bit. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Cheers, mate. Oh, look at this. This is fucking epic. Epic, mate. Wow. Amazing. I'm just gonna stay here because I don't want that to fall in my head, honestly.
Drive forward.
Yeah?
We're in the building here.
In the building, yeah? Nice one. Yeah, you only need this side, but yeah, up to you guys. Just be careful because it's, I've done it once and it's quite painful. Okay. I just finished this job. It's been loads of work here, so didn't have enough battery to record the last part of it. All of us done manual handling there. And we just took it one by one. Like that polystyrene thingy, just hand them one by one. And another two guys, they just going all the time indoors, just going back to the yard. I'll reverse it there.
Put it in front of it, mate.
Yeah, no worries, mate.
Just in case it's got a little mesh on it.
Yeah. Thank you. little bit further out because they need to operate the lorries. Literally can't see anything in the mirror here. I want to thank you so much for watching this episode. Stay tuned, there will be much more to come in. Thank you very much. Cheers.